my chariot get ya. The door's open. Take the hot road and hop in. First impression.
It's Friday for me too.
I'm really excited to record my first Get Ready With Me video. I actually have a couple coming back to back down the pipeline because I've got tonight's event and I've got another event next week. So tonight, I'm going with Lincoln to the mother-son dance, father-daughter dance. It's actually just parent-child dance at our school. So I am going to take off my makeup from the day, wash my face, have a quick shower, and turn it all around and get ready. And while I do that, I want to talk about Lincoln and why I'm not homeschooling Lincoln. So I just did a video explaining why Kofi and I made the decision to homeschool Laya. And I want to talk about some of the reasons why we are not homeschooling Lincoln. He's still in traditional school. Why is that? So I'm going to talk about that while I get ready for the dance. Exfoliate, the renegotiate. So I just grabbed a headband, taking off all of my makeup from the day. Oh, and by the way, welcome back to my channel. And if this is your first time at this channel, welcome to the channel. This is a channel that's all about modern motherhood. I talk a lot about family, entrepreneurship, fashion, all things related to modern motherhood and this life that we're living. So if that resonates with you, please hang out, subscribe. Don't forget to like and comment and leave your feedback. Today was pretty low key. We weren't too intense on homeschooling because we are celebrating Laya's birthday. We're in the beginning of her birthday celebration. Laya's turning 11 next week. And so we had a joint birthday celebration with a really dear friend. Later in the month, Laya's going to have a birthday party, but she's mostly inviting just her soccer team. So there are a couple of people that we want to make sure that we spend some time with to celebrate who aren't a part of the soccer team, but are still an important part of her life. So we did that today. I just got done packing for the kids because we're headed down to Temecula at 6 a.m. tomorrow morning for the first game of our State Cup championship run. So hopefully you had a chance to check out my video, The Art of Coaching Your Own Child. I do coach Laya's soccer team. I'm really excited about the State Cup tournament that we have coming up. I also am going to be vlogging our entire State Cup process, so please look out for that if you're into it. If you are a parent of an athlete or parent coach, I think you'll probably enjoy the entire process that we're going through. Just trying to get all of this makeup off, and then I'm going to jump in the shower and basically redo my makeup to get ready for this evening. I'm excited. This is my first time going to the parent-child dance with Lincoln, just the two of us. Last year we all went as a family because it was Laya's last year of elementary school, and Kofi took Laya and Lincoln took me. So we did that, all four of us ended up at the dance. I'm hoping that it's gonna be better than last year because Lincoln really didn't dance with me much at all. He ran all around with his little friends. They did like karate moves. I had to watch out so I didn't get hurt. I'm hoping that he's gonna bring a more gentlemanly demeanor to this date night tonight. So we'll see what happens. I'm hoping, but I'm not holding my breath. All right, I think that's mostly off. I'm going to wash my face and pop in the shower, and I will be back when I'm going to put my makeup on. I'm getting started. It's on. People can hear you.
Good.
People can hear you. Exactly. You see how you really are. Wow! Oh my God! So I am just in the process getting ready. Just got out of the shower, getting ready to go to this mother-son dance with Lincoln. It's gonna be super cute and super fun. But I just wanted to talk to you guys about why we are only homeschooling Laya, or she's in the homeschool hybrid program. So she does go to school 2 days a week, but why we are only opting to do that program for her and not for Lincoln. The underlying reason why we're homeschooling Laya, but we're not homeschooling Lincoln, it seems pretty obvious and self-explanatory, but I would articulate it as they are just fundamentally different children. They have different personalities, they're at different ages, they're at different stages of development. So even if they were twins, we would have to really ask ourselves, is what's right for one also what's right for the other? But in this situation, they're just totally at different places and stages in their development. So Laya is a very social girl. She always has been extroverted, outgoing, more of a type A personality. Whereas Lincoln is more of an introvert. Just a different kind of personality, not necessarily as outspoken as she is. We've definitely had to work with him quite a bit on his social and emotional development. I'd say far more than Laya at this stage. And you guys are just watching me put on like 50 different kinds of moisturizer and serum and all that stuff. I actually had a spa day yesterday, so I did a 4-layer resurfacing facial at Burke Williams. So I have like taken off 4 years of my life, I feel like, with peels yesterday. But I just want to make sure I'm really well moisturized before I start putting on my makeup for tonight. And as you guys are seeing me drink this Prosecco, I just want to let you know that we live within walking distance from where, the venue where this parent-child dance is going to be. It's actually going to be at our community recreational center, one of the two that we have called the Center Point Club. So I could walk home, but I think Kofi is actually going to drop us off and pick us up since Lincoln can't drive. So I appreciate both of my children for different reasons. I think they take after each one of us in different ways. I actually feel as though I'm the one who's a bit more introverted. I have an outgoing, adaptive personality because we move so much. But Kofi's definitely our resident extrovert in our relationship. Very, very outgoing, gregarious, friendly. I mean, obviously, that's why he's been so successful in sales and real estate. And, you know, so that's kind of in alignment with his personality. So, you know, Laya takes after him in that regard. But as I said, I can also be outgoing and gregarious. And I do like to interact with people and host people. I just know that I really, really need that recovery time, as Lincoln does as well. While I definitely don't want him to feel like there's anything wrong with being introverted, I definitely think that it's really important for him to be able to negotiate his weaknesses and to develop an adaptive personality that is more outgoing. So that's something that I have learned to do, and I think it served me really well. Because of the way that our society is structured, sometimes we value people with a different kind of communication style, people who can show that A-type communication style. So by all means, I want him to be able to opt into and opt out of the different kinds of skill sets that will serve him with what he wants to do. I actually really value Lincoln's introvertedness because it gives him a unique ability to focus. Really, these decisions that we're making are about what's in the best interest of our child, and they're really more pull factors than push factors. We like the elementary school that our children attend. Oops, I'm gonna watch what I'm doing here. We like the elementary school that our children attend. And they've had a lot of success and great teachers. I think what I found in the traditional school model is that it's really teacher to teacher as far as the quality of the education that you're gonna get. Whether it's public school or private school, that's just my opinion. So you really, really, really gotta value those teachers. the good ones.
Right now at the school that Lincoln attends, we're pleased with the level of challenge that he is able to get within the context of his classroom. And then I do supplement his learning with additional materials. We also are really pleased with the diversity that's at the school, which is another important factor for us.
So it's definitely really individual. You've got to take it child by child and figure out where they are in their developmental trajectory, whether it's with academics or athletics or whatever else their special gift might be. It could be music. Lincoln's only 7 years old right now, and he still has time to cultivate his talent. At the stage that Laya's at, approaching middle school, now's really the time for her to dig in and take her training more seriously if she wants to pursue soccer at a collegiate or higher level. But Lincoln's just not there right now. That was one of the factors that we used when we were making that decision ultimately to homeschool Laya, and it just doesn't apply to Lincoln where he is right now. So I'm definitely running out of time. So I'm gonna have to speed it up here. You know, I think a lot of times we're usually trying to protect our children or even lean into where their strengths and advantages could be too soon. I think it's important to be able to negotiate some of the weaknesses before you start really digging in and leaning into where you think they have advantages. So for example, for Laya, being a person who I think is a pretty quick learner, as is Lincoln, but her just being a really quick learner, something that I put her in really early was just art classes, fine art classes. So she really had to slow down, because you literally have to slow down and watch paint dry and take your time and become invested in process. Same thing with why I thought violin would be an excellent choice for her, because definitely she can learn things quickly, but I want to teach her how to learn things slowly. So I think, you know, when it comes to making this choice, you have to think about where your child is and not just what their strengths are, but what are the weaknesses that you want to help them negotiate through adaptation.
Sometimes individuality, creativity, and focus are challenges in group settings in traditional schools, but that's actually where Lincoln's strengths already lie.
Another consideration for me is really just thinking about how much I can bear. It's not easy. I know from teaching experience that it's not always easy to teach students that are in vastly different places when it comes to their development, and especially young students. So when you have like students that are older, high school, college age, they take more responsibility for their learning than do elementary and middle school students. Middle school is just that point where you're starting to transition them to be able to take more responsibility. So I just thought that it would be also, you know, a little bit difficult negotiating two vastly different curriculums where they're both at pretty important stages of their learning. So, you know, at second grade, third grade, Lincoln's between a third and fourth grade reading level now. He's in the second grade. He skipped a grade like Laya, so they're both a year ahead in school. So, you know, he's just at a stage where his learning is also pretty important and needs to be regimented. It's not like a preschool style learning. Not that preschool isn't important, but there's, I think, a lot more flexibility in the younger ages, and it becomes a little bit less flexible in terms of what needs to be delivered on and the skills that need to be delivered and assessed as they get older in elementary school. So just thinking about the burden of really negotiating two completely different levels of curriculum. Oh, Lincoln's out of the shower. Here you go, sir. Here's your stuff. And your pants are clean. They're downstairs, okay? Are you ready?
Yeah.
Ready, 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 getting
no!
ready. Okay, listen. Okay, so none of this is really looking that even, but thank God it's gonna be dark in there, because again, I'm running out of time. Running out of time. But again, time is one of the considerations. Would I have time to be able to deliver a quality experience to the two student children that I have who are at different places developmentally? I didn't really think so. Another thing about Lincoln is that it's actually still pretty difficult to get him to sit down and finish his homework in a timely fashion. We are still having a bit of drama with regard to homework. I say still, but really with Laya, I never really had that experience. She was just a much more compliant child, and Lincoln is a bit more of a willful child. That's his brand. So I think also when he's older and a little bit more mature and further along in his development, it'll be easier for him to sit and be ready to learn and experience the lessons in a one-to-one kind of situation. Not just one-to-one, but one-to-one with mom. I think that's the big difference.
But I am looking forward to a time where we are ready to homeschool together. Lincoln is an exceptionally creative and bright student, and he's amazing with mathematics and engineering, and it's going to be a lot of fun.
Okay, at this point, I'm super duper late, but I think I'll get better over time with the talking while I'm getting ready and all that. almost time to leave here, folks. I think Lincoln and I are gonna have a great time, though. He looks super sharp. I had to stop and help him get ready.
Hi, my name's Lincoln, and today's the daddy-daughter dance, but for me it's the mother-son dance, and I'm wearing, as you can see, I'm wearing this suit with a tie and a scarf, and my mom's wearing a dress that matches my scarf. If you want to see, then here you go.
First impression. This is the dress that matches Lincoln's scarf. We're gonna take real pictures, and we will add those pictures to this vlog, and we will also add some video of us getting our groove on, because Lincoln is a great dancer. So we're gonna do that, huh? We're gonna have fun. If you OPN, engaging is on my agenda. Request my chariot, get ya. The door's OPN. Take the hot road and hop in. Monarch butterflies, you should open up.
I didn't know what to expect when I found out that I was having a boy, but Lincoln has been such a blessing in my life. He adds so much joy and happiness and creativity and just lateral thinking. He's such an interesting child. And as I said, even though I think right now it probably makes more sense for me to focus on homeschooling Laya in the hybrid program that she's in and allow Lincoln to continue to grow and develop in the traditional school model, I am looking forward to the opportunity to have that one-on-one time with him in the near future.